So you're probably wondering, hey, Robert, why are you hanging out in this nice, comfortable chair in your bonus room instead of where you have all your stuff set up? Well, I'm going to tell you why. Because today, I am going to show you and review my brand new Samsung S90D OLED TV. And I'm going to tell you, I've never had an OLED TV before, and this right here has sold me. This is amazing. So let's get to it. So here is the 2024 Samsung S90D OLED TV. And I'm going to tell you, it's awesome. As you can see, I've already got my PlayStation hooked up. I got my Xbox hooked up. I got my steering wheel over there for when I want to do some Gran Turismo. And this thing has been amazing to watch shows on and watch movies and to do my gaming. It's actually brought the gaming to a whole new level because it's so realistic, because the PS5 can do 4K at 120 hertz. And this TV is capable of up to 144 hertz variable refresh rate. And it has the auto low latency mode. So when you are connected to the PlayStation, it just automatically turns that on. But first, I just want to show you the picture clarity. So I'm going to turn this 4K preview on right here. And just hopefully you can get an idea of how spectacular that looks. The visuals on this TV are unbelievable. Simply amazing. Look how clear that is. So here's the home screen. And of course you have all of the apps that you can sign into, whatever you're using. Obviously there's more that you can add if you wanted to add more. I do really like over here, they have this game bar that takes you into a whole different section for gaming, where you can actually do some cloud gaming. That's for the Xbox Game Pass, the NVIDIA GeForce Now. Of course, they have the Alexa Luna network, and these are all cloud gaming. So you could just go in there and game right on the television itself. Now, I don't have any of those accounts. I used to have a GeForce Now account, but when I got my PlayStation, I discontinued that because I didn't use it anymore. And of course, there's my PlayStation 5. So when I turn the PlayStation 5 on, I just got to click on that and it will take me into the actual game. But this gives you the ability of controlling whatever settings you want, like right on the fly. And it's just the interface in typical Samsung fashion is smooth. It's fast, it's easy to manage. You can do all your connected devices in one place. It has built-in smart things, so if you have a smart things home like I do, you can come in here and manage all your devices right from the television. As you can see, it shows you like temperature, it shows you I have a Samsung refrigerator, so I could actually, you know, go in here and look at what's in my refrigerator. I'm not really sure the whole point of that, but it tells me my door is closed. There's my SmartThings station that's downstairs. I have a smart tag that's connected. I have a lot of Samsung things, and it's the ability to manage them all here is actually pretty nice. So it's just one more feature that they give you. Now, one thing they have is Samsung has this Samsung TV Plus, and I don't really watch it much, but I have watched it here and there, like when I've just been kind of bored. It actually has a lot of programs on it. And it's absolutely free with the TV. So I have now three Samsung televisions and they all have the application on it. And you can watch all kinds of different TV shows, movies, regular TV programs. And it's actually really nice. So you wouldn't even need to pay for television if you wanted to watch this. So yeah, it's pretty awesome. Yeah, the interface is just so smooth and nice. And of course you can go into this ambient mode. And what that'll do is just kind of change the screen to like a static image where you can have a picture or something displayed. I guess if you wanted to like use it as a, I don't know, like a picture frame, you could. I don't really utilize that, but it does look pretty good and it works pretty well. So as you can see, it just has these this like wooded area just kind of floating around on the screen. So I guess you could leave that running if you wanted to. I don't really use it, but I guess it's nice to have if you want to take advantage of it. So one other thing I wanted to show you is, and you're going to get to see all the wires, but look how thin this television is. I mean, you can't get much thinner than that. I mean, that's crazy thin. And it's just technology these days with these television stuff, man, it's just getting crazy, unbelievable. I can only imagine what an 8K TV would look like. Now, I actually opted for this 55-inch instead of a 65-inch. I actually have gamed on 55-inch and 65-inch, and I like the 55-inch size better anyways. And as you can see, where I sit is not that far from the TV, so it actually works out really, really well. So there's my little studio area, if you will. Got it all set up. Kind of moved some things around and rearranged it, so looks a little bit better. It's just awesome. And so as you can see, that Samsung TV is phenomenal. And so far, the amount of watching I've done and game playing I've done, I can't recommend it enough. It is fantastic. One cool thing is that if you purchase the TV or any of their 2024 line, even the QLEDs, during their pre-order promotion, they were giving away a 65-inch 4K TV that you see right here. That's pretty cool. Now, I obviously haven't unboxed that. I don't have anywhere to put it in the house. I'm probably going to either end up giving it to a family or friend or family member, or maybe I'll sell it. We'll see. I don't know. Right now, it's going to sit in the box up against the wall. But it's pretty awesome if you're able to get one of those during that pre-sale. That was a pretty phenomenal deal. So that was kind of one thing that kind of pushed me over the edge. I had an older LCD TV in here that just wasn't performing well. It's 1080. I mean, it's all right, but it didn't obviously have a lot of the amazing features this new one has. So because they gave that TV away, I thought, man, that's a great deal. If I do sell it, I'll end up having this TV for probably $700 or $800 because I was able to actually get a discount too, because my wife being a nurse, we get a Samsung gives a pretty phenomenal discount to first responders, which is amazing. So at any rate, I can't recommend it enough. Even if you didn't get one during the pre-sale, if you're looking for a new TV, go check out the 2024 line of the Samsung products. And you can't go wrong, whether it's a QLED or an OLED, their TVs are fantastic. I have a 2020 65-inch QLED downstairs in the living room, and the picture on it's phenomenal too. So I can't say bad about anything as far as our TVs go. They're all just fantastic. Now, obviously, the OLED takes the level a little higher because, you know, blacks are blacks, the colors are popping. It's just phenomenal, phenomenal. Now, another aspect was I had purchased a light kit for the back of this TV, because downstairs on my 65-inch, I have a Philips Hue sync box with the gradient light strip around the back for when I do, you know, watch on that television. And it works fantastic, but it does not support 4K at 120 hertz. So I stopped using it for gaming when I had my PlayStation downstairs, because I wanted the 120 hertz because I found the gaming experience just to be a lot smoother. So when the Light Me came out with their new Fantasy 3 sync box that supports 4K, 120 hertz, variable refresh rate, auto low latency mode, I was like, oh man, that's fantastic. I'm going to try that out. And it's less expensive, because a Philips Hue sync box with the gradient light strip is going to run you probably $400. But here's the thing, and I've said this many times, it works. You just don't have issues. So this is what I purchased, okay? And this is the Light Me Fantasy 3 sync box with the LED light strip to go on the back of the TV. And it was like $175 on sale on Amazon. So I was really excited for this. And I watched a lot of reviews. People say, oh, this thing is awesome. Not my experience at all. And actually, it's boxed back up. As you can see, I had it installed, but I took it off because it didn't work. I couldn't get it to work on my PS5. It would work on the Xbox, but the PS5 was just a black screen. No matter what I did, I changed cables, I reset the device, I changed the video settings on the PS5, I changed video settings on the TV. I went through everything twice, and I couldn't get the screen to show any video at all from my PlayStation. And the cables I'm using are all 8K cables. They're all fairly new, high-end HDMI cables that support high bandwidth, and nothing. Again, perfect on the Xbox. Couldn't watch or play anything on the PS5. And I do, well, 100% of my gaming really on the PS5. I do have a few games on the Xbox, but I don't really play it much. I usually will play, you know, the Modern Warfare 2, Modern Warfare 3, Dying Light. I do Gran Turismo, all on my PlayStation. And so I was super excited for this. In addition to that, when I did use it on the Xbox, I wanted to see how it worked. You could already see the lights. They were dim. They weren't even that bright. And, you know, some of these videos I watch, and I watch, it looked like the lights were bright. Now, maybe I just got a bad one. I don't know. But it has completely turned me off to this product, and I will not be purchasing another one. I did reach out to their support like 2 days ago and have yet to hear anything. So I don't know what the deal is, but I just got frustrated because I'm not going to spend $175 on something and then have to, you know, for one, go through all the trouble of trying to get it to work and then still not work. It's insane. And this is part of the problem with some of these components that, yeah, I don't know if it's development or what it is, but it just doesn't work. You know, when I first set it up, I had an issue even getting it connected to the wireless because they only support the legacy 2.4 Wi-Fi, and I couldn't get it to connect unless I went into my mesh system and isolated the 2.4 and reduced it down to old legacy settings, and then it connected. And then I could put everything back, and once it connected, then it would reconnect, no problem. But it was getting it connected. And again, you shouldn't have to do that. I mean, come on, people. These manufacturers, it is time to start supporting 2.4 and 5 gigahertz in your products. That way you don't have to worry about it. All my Nest cameras will connect at 5 gigahertz if it's strong enough. If not, it fails back to 2.4. I don't have to change anything. My Philips Hue system, I don't have to change anything. It just connects. So they need to really get that situation resolved because it's kind of ridiculous in my opinion. But I was super disappointed, and for right now I am not going to have any lights behind the TV because Philips Hue does not have a sync box that supports 4K at 120 hertz, and the gaming experience on this OLED with the variable refresh rate and all the other features is to me just fantastic, and I'm not going to reduce my gaming experience to get the lights. So as you saw, I did have some, you know, lights that kind of sit on the table. I'll just use for ambient light because I do like to have it behind the TV. But I will end up getting, I think, some like light bars for the side and get rid of that thing on the bottom. I just kind of put that back there for a filler, so to speak. But so super happy with the TV. Very disappointed with the Lightme Fantasy 3 sync box and LED lights. Not worth it. I can't recommend it. So go look for something else. You know, maybe the Govi system with the camera works a lot better, but I don't want a camera on top of the TV, so I'm not going to be purchasing that either. I've watched videos in it. It seems like it works all right, but you know, I don't want a camera on top of the TV. It was kind of the whole point of the sync box. Anyways, so definitely Samsung OLED. That's a definite go. Lightme Fantasy 3 sync box. That's a definite no. If you have any different experience with this Lightme device, I would sure love to hear about it. But at this point, I just can't see myself purchasing another one, which is disappointing because I was so looking forward to having some awesome lights back behind the TV for gaming. Now, and I can tell you, as far as the brightness goes, I had everything maxed out, and this room is not real bright. I mean, I have my lights I'm using for my, you know, videos, but these lights aren't even on when I'm gaming. And even during the day with the lights off, this room is fairly dark. and it's just not bright. Downstairs on the Philips Hue system, the room is really bright during the day, and those lights are super bright, very, very visible. I mean, you can see right here, here's a picture of what the lights look like, and that's during the day. So, I mean, I couldn't get anywhere near that. It's crazy. I'm actually going to put a link to my gaming channel too, because that's where I do all my, post all my gaming videos. So you can go check it out if you want. Don't forget to hit that like and subscribe button, and you'll definitely want to go check out this video here for some other smart home devices that you can put in your home that just make things easier and more secure.